The next issue that the next basically the portion that which is the part of the body that which helps in providing the immunity, as we were already starting the immunity. So this is the lymphoid tissue or the lymphoid organs, right? The lymphoid organs, they are also basically involved as the major sources for providing the immunity to us. The various of the lymphoid organs, that is, they can be categorized as the primary organs which are involved for basically helping in the maturation or the differentiation of the cells, as well as the T lymphocytes, as well as the further functioning of these in killing up of the bacteria or the other microbes that which are causing the diseases. So these are the lymphoid organs that which help us, that is, in fighting against the particular diseases or building up the immunity defense. Okay, so categorizing these lymphoid organs as the primary ones. The primary organs, for example, which are involved in differentiation or maturation of the lymphocytes, they are, for example, the bone marrow, right, that plays a major role. Also, thymus. What is this bone marrow and the thymus? Bone marrow and thymus, especially, they are helpful in providing the maturation and differentiation to the T lymphocytes, right? The bone marrow, where the cells, they get originated, where they are formed, right? And thymus, it is a small little gland. You must have studied in 11th, if you remember, in the chapter of the glands, endocrine glands, jahan pe humne padhe the chemical control and coordination of neural control, chemical control and coordination chapter mein, okay? So thymus is a small little, you can say, a structure within our body, an organ within our body. When the infants, they are born, they are provided the immunity with the help of this thymus, right? This is initially having a particular size when the infants are born, but as the person grows, that is, as we mature up, the thymus size that reduces, okay? And this is placed near the heart, okay? And ye kya hai? Basically, it is involved in providing the immunity at the initial stages of the birth. Theek hai, jabhi ek newborn birth leta hai, us samay pe, this is the one which is going to create the immunity, okay? So that is thymus, right? There are other organs also which work after the maturation, when the T lymphocytes have been matured enough, they are differentiated, that is, they are ready for their functioning. Then comes the secondary organs, the secondary lymphoid organs, that, for example, are spleen. Sabse pehle spleen hai, there is an example of spleen is there. Lymph nodes are there, pear patches are there. And then, so there are certain of this, certain, you can say, the tissues that which are involved or the organs which are involved for providing the immunity. What is the role of the spleen and where it is located? Spleen is just present near the stomach, or we can say near the pancreas. It's a small bean-shaped structure, okay? At the tip of the pancreas, towards the tip of the pancreas, the spleen is present. And the spleen also acts as a graveyard of the RBCs, we know. Okay, but RBCs ka yahan pe in providing the immunity koi role nahi hai. Here in this, that is providing the immunity, spleen, which is acting as a secondary lymphoid organ, this basically provides the, you can say, filtration to the blood-borne microbes. Okay, jo microbes blood se travel karte hai hamari puri body mein, that is, they make an entry to the various organs, provide various symptoms, provide various infections, that are all filtered out over here in this particular organ. And so are the lymph nodes, lymph nodes. In this lymph nodes, what is happening? They are also acting as the filtration units, but for the all the other pathogens or the microbes, okay? That is, which are entering through the skin or which are entering, having an entrance point from anywhere else, but from the blood, it is specifically when it is the spleen which plays an action, whereas the lymph nodes. Lymph nodes kya hoti hai? These are the smaller swollen areas over the lymphatic vessels, okay? Jahan pe lymph jo hai wo carry kari jati hai. Lymph is also the rich source of the WBCs, we know, you know, that has the plasma along with the WBCs only. So there are certain swollen areas that which are also acting as the filtration units for the other microbes, right? Other than this, we also have the lymphoid tissue that is associated with the many of the linings of the various systems, like that of the respiratory tracts. है ना, उनकी लाइनिंग के साथ एसोसिएटेड हो सकती है लिम्फोइड टिश्यू, या फिर यूरोजेनाइटल ट्रैक्ट्स हैं, ठीक है, गैस्ट्रोइंटेस्टाइनल ट्रैक्ट हैं, तो उनके साथ ये लिम्फोइड टिश्यू जो है ये एसोसिएट हो सकता है. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज माल्ट, ठीक है, वी आल्सो कॉल इट एज माल्ट. व्हाट इज दिस? It is mucosa associated. Mucosa means the mucosal lining, that of the various tracts. So mucosa associated lymphoid tissue, that is marked. Okay, so this also provides the cleaning of the various microbes from within the particular tracts. Okay, so that is marked. Getting? So these are the various lymphoid organs that are the primary or the secondary, providing their particular functions in providing immunity to our body. Okay, so coming to the next are the two diseases, that is number one is the AIDS and second is the cancer. In details, the two diseases which we have to study are, first is AIDS. Now, what is the full form of AIDS? That is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. It is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Every word has an emphasis over there. What do you mean by the acquired diseases? Acquired is a category of the diseases. Starting में हमने पढ़ाया था, आपको अगर याद है, the three classifications we have studied. Number one classification was of infectious and non-infectious, है ना? Second was that of acute and chronic, and third was that of congenital and acquired, right? So this is acquired. It is acquired during the lifespan. It may be acquired because of the any of the means जो आगे हम पढ़ेंगे. So that is, it is a kind of the disease which is acquired, right? Second, it is an immunodeficiency disease. Means it's a disease in which the immune system gets deficient. Means the person's immune system is broken down, and so the person may be prone to any type of the diseases. Here the main is immune system breakdown is there with this disease. And it is a syndrome. Syndrome means what? Anyone who knows what is the meaning of the syndrome? Raise your hand. No answer. So syndrome is what? Syndrome means that is a collection of the symptoms. Actually, क्या होता है, कभी कोई एक disease होती है, जैसे कुछ भी disease है, let's say pneumonia is there, typhoid is there, आप लोगों ने अभी पढ़ी है ना, तो उनमें कुछ particular symptoms हैं जो कि एक particular system के साथ related है ना. अगर हमने बात करा that there are symptoms which are related to respiration, है ना, coughing is there, mucus which is given out from the lungs or the alveoli, fluid filled sac हो जाती है ना. तो ये सारी चीजें क्या है, दे आर ऑल एसोसिएटेड ओनली द रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट, है ना, एक सिस्टम के साथ. तो एक सिस्टम के अलग अलग ऑर्गन्स में अगर कोई डिफरेंस, मतलब कुछ डिफरेंशियल वर्किंग आ जाती है, फंक्शनिंग आ जाती है, तो हम उसको कहते हैं सिम्टम, है ना. लेकिन अगर एक ऑर्गन नहीं बल्कि मोर देन ऑर्गन्स, मोर देन द वन ऑर्गन्स ऑफ द वन सिस्टम के अलावा अगर बाकी ऑर्गन्स में भी सिम्टम्स आने शुरू हो जाए, यानी थ्रू आउट द बॉडी कोई भी सिस्टम, कोई भी ऑर्गन अगर इसमें बहुत सारे सिम्टम्स प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं, देन वी कॉल इट एज अ सिंड्रोम. सिंपली सेइंग वी कैन से सिंड्रोम इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ सिम्टम्स. ठीक है, सिम्टम्स का कलेक्शन मींस बहुत सारे सिम्टम्स, बहुत सारे ऑर्गन्स इन्फेक्ट हो गए और जिसकी वजह से ये सिंड्रोम बन गया. बेसिकली इट इज अ इम्यून सिस्टम ब्रेकडाउन ना, तो इम्यून के साथ बहुत सारे ऑर्गन्स जो है वो कनेक्टेड है, दे ऑल गेट ब्रोकन डाउन हेयर बिकॉज ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर डिजीज, दैट इज एड्स, राइट. Always write AIDS like this in capitals. Don't write it in running hand with a small IDS. Okay. Next is, what causes it? What is the causative agent for this AIDS? The causal agent or the causative agent for this particular disease, that is HIV. HIV means human immunovirus. इसको ये भी कह सकते हैं human immunovirus. या हम यहाँ पे बीच में इम्यूनो और वायरस के बीच में डेफिशिएंसी भी ऐड कर सकते हैं, दैट इज ह्यूमन इम्यूनो डेफिशिएंसी वायरस. बट दिस इज कैपिटल अल्फाबेट्स ओनली HIV. डेफिशिएंसी लिखना है तो डी स्मॉल लिख दे. ठीक है, सो इट इज ह्यूमन इम्यूनो वायरस दैट विच इज कॉजिंग द डिजीज, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एड्स. ओके, टू व्हाट कैटेगरी ऑफ द वायरसेस डज इट बिलोंग? दिस बिलोंग्स टू द कैटेगरी ऑफ द retroviruses. They have a very thick protein coat around the genetic material. Because of that thick proteinaceous coat which is present around the genetic material, it is very you can say difficult to to fight with this particular virus if it enters into our body. Okay, if the HIV enters into the person's body, human's body, then it becomes very, very difficult to fight against this particular virus, because it belongs to the such a, you can say, complex type of the structured viruses. They are called as the retrovirus, having the thick proteinaceous coat over it. Okay, done. Now, what are the various methods by which it is transmitted from one person to the another? That is, what are the means of transmission, or what are the various means of its spread? Okay, what are the various means of the transmission of this particular disease, and what are the various means of the spread of this particular disease, that is AIDS? How it is getting transmitted? Number one, this is transmitted by the sexual method or the sexual contact. During copulation, if one partner is having the particular disease, that is AIDS, then with the sexual contact, that is with the transfusions, we can say the virus may be transmitted from one person to the another. Okay, that is, it is transmitted with the sexual contact with the infected person, we can say. Okay, the first method is by sexual contact. Second is by using the infected needles, that is the sterilized needles jo na ho. For example, जैसे आप लोगों ने सिंपल ब्लड ट्रांसफ्यूजन ही करवाना है हमने, ठीक है, और वी हैव टू गेट द वैक्सीनेशन इंजेक्शंस, राइट? सो एट दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम, इफ द सिरिंजेस, दीज आर ऑलरेडी यूज्ड टू पर्टिकुलर पर्संस, मतलब अलग अलग लोगों को ऑलरेडी वो सिरिंज यूज करी गई है और उसको स्टेरलाइज नहीं किया और वापस इट इज बीइंग एडेड टू द अदर पीपल, देन ऑल्सो द ब्लड ट्रांसफ्यूजन इज देयर, एंड विद दैट ऑल्सो दिस डिजीज मे हैपन फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन टू द नॉर्मल हेल्दी पर्सन. सो वी कैन से it is by using the non sterilized needles, theek hai, non sterilized needles. Basically these needles are also used in the intravenous drugs. Wo jo drugs lene wale jo log hote hain, drugs abusers, so they can also get this particular disease when they are using these needles in the intravenous transfusions, or also for the blood transfusions. Theek hai, blood transfusions aap alag se point bana sakte hain. And this is for the drug abusers, you can write. Okay, so during the blood transfusion also, if the doctors, they are using the non sterilized needles, that is if it is injected within our skin and that is not sterilized before it's used to the human body, that is for the transfusion of the blood, then also it can happen from the infected person to the normal healthy person, right? There is one mean that when the mother, while conceived, she is also infected from the AIDS, and that infection can go to the fetus. Okay, so the infected mother to healthy fetus was, otherwise it could have been healthier na when at birth, because they are healthy, they are not infected by AIDS at least. But it is one condition when the mother is infected. If the mother is already having this particular disease, that is AIDS, then the fetus may also get this disease. Okay, so these are a few of the by using the sharpened objects of the AIDS infected person, ye bhi likh sakte hain. So using sharpened objects, why sharpened only? That is because, again, using the sharpened objects, the person's blood that comes in contact with one another, where this virus lies, and that may lead to the disease. Okay, using sharpened objects of AIDS infected person, that may also lead to the transmission of this particular disease, that is AIDS. Getting? Now, within the human body, how does this virus, when it enters into the human body, how it grows? That is, what actually helps in the transmission of this particular disease, the viruses or the microbes, into the full body? ठीक है, ये कैसे जा पाते हैं? That is with the help of the you can say human's own body cellular mechanisms. ठीक है, human body के या host body के अपने ही cells जो हैं वो involve होते हैं for basically spreading this disease throughout the body. Okay, and how it works, how the replication of this virus takes place, how it creates an infection in the whole of the body. So that is replication of retroviruses. Within our body, the very first cells that come in contact, they are the macrophages. Okay, the macrophages, they are the cells that which actually have the phagocytic actions. But here for this particular virus, that is HIV, they are acting as the HIV factories. ठीक है, ये macrophages help करते हैं इन viruses की replication में. Macrophages help करते हैं इनको, macrophages को हम बोलते हैं HIV factories. क्यों? क्योंकि ये multiply कर देते हैं उन viruses को as they enter through the whatever the means, जो भी means हैं, they are making an entry and so they are forming the copies of, ठीक है, a number of the copies of this virus, that is retrovirus or the HIV, right? As I told you that there is a thick proteinaceous coat around it, okay, so this is a protein coat which is protecting it from the surroundings, right, which is protecting the genetic material, that is RNA in the case of this retrovirus HIV. So this is actually protecting the genetic material from the surroundings, right? So this is a retrovirus. When it comes in contact with the host cell, that are the macrophages. So when it comes in contact with the host cell, say this is the host cell, that is a macrophage, okay, that is a macrophage cell. Here when it comes in contact with this, these retroviruses, they infects the host cell. When it infects the host cell, there this covering, that is a protein coat that is left outside only. What goes within is the, ये protein coat जो है ये बाहर ही रह गया उस outer covering से, यानी macrophage cell के बाहर ही रह जाएगा protein coat, अंदर नहीं जाएगा. What is infective in the nature is the RNA, ठीक है. Then this RNA goes and invades within the macrophage. Okay, getting, this is the viral RNA that has invaded, viral RNA that has invaded within the cell, that is a host cell or a macrophage, which acts as a HIV factory. Getting done. Here when it enters, that is this viral RNA, जब ये enter करता है, now this is a single stranded genetic material, that is RNA. It has to be formed into a DNA by which it will be incorporated within the nucleus or the DNA of the host cell itself, है ना? तो यहाँ पे macrophage के अंदर इसका अपना nucleus है, इस nucleus के अंदर उसका अपना genetic material है, ऐसे ही है ना? तो ये genetic material हमारे host cells का क्या है? DNA, है ना? But ये क्या है? RNA. So means RNA has to be converted into a DNA first, and then only it will make an incorporation, है ना? So this viral RNA that further gets changed or transformed into the DNA with the help of the reverse of the transcription process. Transcription में क्या होता है? Double stranded DNA produces a single stranded RNA. पर यहाँ पे single stranded RNA ने double stranded DNA बना दिया. तो मतलब same straight away transcription नहीं चलेगी, reverse transcription चलेगी. And the enzyme involved here is the reverse transcriptase. What is the enzyme involved? That is reverse transcriptase. So in the presence of reverse transcriptase, you write this, this is reverse transcriptase. With the help of the reverse transcriptase, what next is being produced? That is a double stranded DNA. Now we can call it as a viral DNA. क्या बना यहाँ पे? वायरल डीएनए, है ना? दिस वायरल डीएनए गेट्स इनकॉर्पोरेटेड विद इन द होस्ट डीएनए. ओके, सो दिस इज गेटिंग, गेट्स इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इनटू होस्ट जीनोम. होस्ट के जीनोम के अंदर ये इनकॉर्पोरेट हो जाएगा, डीएनए के अंदर चला जाएगा। अब जैसे जैसे ये सेल डिवाइड करेगा, न्यूक्लियस डिवाइड करेगा, डीएनए डिवाइड करेगा, साथ साथ इसका डीएनए वायरस का डीएनए भी तो डिवाइड करेगा, है ना। तो वायरल डीएनए इज ऑल्सो गेटिंग डिवाइडेड, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस व्हेन दिस डीएनए हैज टू प्रोवाइड द ट्रांसक्रिप्शन, इसने जब ट्रांसक्रिप्शन देनी है, आरएनए बनाना है, तो वहां पे वापस फिर से यही वाला वायरल आरएनए फिर से सिंथेसाइज हो जाएगा इन द सेम नेचर, इन द सेम फॉर्म, है ना। सो इट इज गेटिंग इनकॉर्पोरेटेड विद इन द डीएनए एंड एज अ रिजल्ट द न्यू वायरल आरएनए विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड आउट ऑफ इट। ठीक है, सो व्हाट इज गेटिंग आउट ऑफ इट आर द न्यू वायरल आरएनए। आप ये सिंपल इस तरह से शो कर सकते हो सिंगल स्ट्रैंड में, तो दे आर द न्यू वायरल आरएनए। ठीक है, सो दिस इज अ वायरल आरएनए, एज अ रिजल्ट द न्यू वायरल आरएनए आर प्रोड्यूस्ड, न्यू वायरल आरएनए, ये इसके ऊपर आप पूरा लिख सकते हो इस एरो पे, न्यू वायरल आरएनए आर प्रोड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्टेड होस्ट सेल आउट फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्टेड होस्ट न्यूक्लियस। ठीक है, इन्फेक्टेड सेल से, from infected cell, and these RNA when they come out along with their own nature, that is again having the coat around it, protein coat, सारे features उसको वापस मिल जाएंगे फिर से, and then there is RNA which is again getting the, you can say, a structure which is infective again. So this is one RNA virus has entered into the cell and it has produced many. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे आप बहुत सारे भी शो कर सकते हो। इट हैज प्रोड्यूस्ड मेनी ऑफ दीज वायरसेस, दीज विच विल बी इन्फेक्टिंग द न्यू सेल्स। सो दीज आर द न्यू वायरसेस इन्फेक्टिंग न्यू सेल्स। ओके, दैट कैन इफेक्ट द अदर सेल्स, गॉट इट। सो न्यू वायरसेस विच कैन इफेक्ट द अदर सेल्स, they are being produced by the incorporation into the nucleus or the DNA of the host cell. So this is the nucleus, label it as nucleus, and the DNA of the host cell. Okay, so this is how the replication of the retrovirus takes place. And ji beta getting, this is how the replication of this retrovirus takes place. Initially, the retrovirus makes an entry into the host cell, leaving the protein coat there only. ठीक है, जो viral protein coat है वो वहीं पे रह जाएगा, इसको भी label करने तो लिख दो यहाँ पे। This is the viral protein coat, and what gets infected further, that is what makes an entry, that is the viral RNA. This viral RNA that will be producing the DNA through the reverse transcriptase, है ना? Through reverse transcriptase, when this DNA is being formed, it is going to incorporate into the host's own DNA. This DNA further, after its replication and transcription, leads to the formation of the new RNA strands, which will release out the RNA which was not of its own kind, you know, during replication and during the transcriptions. Now these viral RNA strands, they are multiplied. One has entered and many has been formed. So when they multiply, they will be released into the, out of this macrophage, means within the body cells, within the body system again. Okay, and thereby it creates a new viruses which can infect the other cells. This is how actually the viruses that are the retroviruses or the HIVs, they are basically playing their role, that is for the for this infection. They are multiplying the organisms, HIVs, for the infection, further infection into the body. Anji, have you made this? Any question, any doubt to anyone? Till this. Now further is, how to prevent this particular disease? Matlab, agar ye disease ho jati hai, to prevention kaise lana hai? Yehi sare methods of transmission jo hai, inhi ko humne khatam karna hai. Yani ki yehi prevention methods jo hai, transmission sorry methods jo hai, ye agar hum log inko अलाउ नहीं करते हैं वायरस को किसी भी इस मेथड से आने के लिए, देन डेफिनेटली इट इज प्रिवेंटेड, है ना। द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ दिस एड्स इज नॉट पॉसिबल, डायग्नोसिस होता है, डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्ट इसका है, इसका नाम लिख दीजिए, देयर इज अ डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्ट Diagnostic test, this involves a technique called as ELISA. What is that? Enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. ठीक है, एंजाइम लिंक्ड इम्यूनो सॉर्बेंट असे, मतलब इम्यून सिस्टम का हम लोग इसमें टेस्ट किया जाता है. दैट इज अ डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्ट. इट इज एंजाइम लिंक्ड इम्यूनो सॉर्बेंट असे, एंजाइम लिंक्ड इम्यूनो सॉर्बेंट असे. असे इज केमिकली पूरा प्रोसेस फॉलो करके, स्टेप वाइज मैकेनिज्म फॉलो करके एक पूरा कंटेंट जो है वो फिल्टर आउट किया जाता है, डायग्नोज किया जाता है, वी कैन से, एंड दैट इज डायग्नोस्ड फॉर हैविंग द वायरस इन द बॉडी और नॉट. ओके, इनिशियली दीज एंटी रेट्रोवायरल ड्रग्स दैट विच कैन बी यूज फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर ट्रीटमेंट, दे आर ऑल्सो यूज बट ओनली एट द इनिशियल स्टेजेस. ओके, दे हैव देयर फ्रूटफुल रिजल्ट, यू कैन से, only at the initial stages, but later on if the viruses that multiplies, basically this virus that does not give you the symptoms for long, it may be right, that is the incubation period may be from a few months to many years, like 10 years tak ho sakta hai, 5 se 10 saal ka usual incubation period hota hai inka. That is incubation period means from the entry of the microbe within the body of a human till the time it produces its first symptom. ओके, तो सिम्टम्स क्या आते हैं, दैट इज दिस पर्टिकुलर पेशेंट, दोज इन द बॉडी ऑफ विच दीज वायरसेस दे आर मल्टीप्लाइंग, दे आर एक्चुअली गेटिंग देयर इम्यून सिस्टम ब्रेकडाउन, सो दे कैन बी प्रोन टू द कॉमन टाइप ऑफ द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑल्सो वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली. ठीक है, तो उनका इम्यून ब्रेकडाउन इतना ज्यादा हो जाता है कि वो हर तरह के माइक्रोब्स के साथ कुछ ना कुछ उनकी बॉडी जो है वो रिएक्शन देती रहती है, डिजीज सिम्टम्स देती रहती है. ठीक है, तो ऐसे जब सिम्टम्स आ जाते हैं मीन्स दीज वायरसेस दे हैव means spread within the body to the unlimited count, है ना. तो वहां पे जब इसको डायग्नोस किया जाएगा तो उस स्टेज पे इसको ट्रीट करवाना इज नॉट पॉसिबल. दोज एंटी रेट्रोवायरल ड्रग्स जो हम जिसकी बात कर रहे थे, दे आर ऑल्सो यूज एट दैट स्टेजेस बट दे आर नॉट फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट देन, बट दे आर ओनली टू, यू कैन से, जस्ट टू लेंथन अप द पीरियड ऑफ द पर्सन स्टे, है ना, यानी कि वो जिंदा थोड़ी और समय के लिए रह सके, दैट इज ओनली फॉर दैट, है ना, बट अदरवाइज इट कांट ट्रीट, ट्रीटमेंट नहीं मिल सकता. डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्ट है, ट्रीटमेंट नहीं है इसका. तो द ओनली वे इज प्रिवेंशन. प्रिवेंशन मींस द पर्सन शुड नॉट हैव द सेक्सुअल कॉन्टैक्ट विद द इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन इफ इट इज नॉट नोन दैट द हु इज द इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन एज वी कांट नो इट. जैसे मैंने अभी बताया इसका इंक्यूबेशन पीरियड जो है वो बहुत ज्यादा होता है. सो द पर्सन शुड नॉट हैव द सेक्सुअल कॉन्टैक्ट विद द मल्टीपल पार्टनर्स इवन. That is also one of the precautionary measure, okay? Because we don't know the persons having the particular disease, okay? Infected with a particular disease. Taking the drugs and that also intravenously through the needles. That is also very much, you can say, fatal, you know, because it is going to lead to this fatal disease, that is AIDS, right? Then the blood transfusions, before getting this particular blood transfusion, the person should we finally, you can say, talking to the doctor for the proper precautions which had been taken or not, है ना. तो blood transfusion के time पे blood sample लेना है, collect करना है. You should be well aware of कि जो आप लोगों का blood transfusions अगर करी जा रही है या किसी patient को blood दिया जा रहा है या लिया जा रहा है किसी samples के लिए या कुछ भी चीज के लिए, आपको जैसे blood test ही करवाना है simple, उसमें जो needles use कर रहे हैं वो are they well sterilized, are they using the new packed needles, or they are using the older ones which are already being used at multiple patients, at the multiple people, hai na. So that should be taken care of. The mother, if she is infected, should not give birth to the child because that will lead to one more person added to the society, which is AIDS infected. Okay, and also to avoid the use of sharpened object with any of the persons because we never know that who else is suffering with this AIDS. Okay, because there are no visual or the no visible type of the symptoms for this particular disease, that is AIDS. Getting? So this is about the AIDS, the diagnostic test, how the infection that spreads within the body, how it spreads from one person to another, what causes it, and what are their prevention measures, right? So after this, there is cancer, and your time is also over. So cancer we'll be studying in the next class. Hanji Vidisha.